0 and CLR 1%. First, we have to know what is parsing. So parser is that phase of compiler which takes token string as input, and with the help of existing grammar, it converts it into the corresponding parse tree. Parser is also known as syntax analyzer. It is mainly classified into two categories, top-down parser and bottom-up parser. The top-down parser is the parser which generates parse for the given input string with the help of grammar productions by expanding the non-terminals. Further, top-down parser is classified into two types, recursive descent parser and non-recursive descent parser. The recursive descent parser is, it basically generates the parse tree by using the brute force and backtracking. And the non-recursive descent parser, which is also known as LL of one parser or predictive parser or without backtracking parser, it uses parsing table to generate the parse tree instead of backtracking. Now let us come to the bottom-up parser. Bottom-up parser is the parser which generates the parse tree for the given input string with the help of grammar productions by compressing the non-terminals. Further, bottom-up parser is classified into two types, LR parser and operator precedence parser. The LR parser is a bottom-up parser which generates the parse tree for the given string by using unambiguous grammar. It follows reverse of rightmost derivation. And LR parser is of four types. First is the LR0, second is the SLR1, which is also called simple LR. Third is the LALR1, that is look ahead LR. And last is the canonical. The operator precedence parser, it generates the parse tree from given grammar and string, but the only condition is two consecutive non-terminals and epsilon never appear in the right-hand side of any production. In order to solve problems on LR0 parsing, the prerequisite is that the LR parser is an efficient bottom-up syntax analysis technique that can be used to large class of context-free grammar. This technique is also called as LR of 0%. The L stands for left-to-right scanning. The R stands for rightmost derivation in reverse. 0 stands for number of input symbols of look ahead. Then comes the steps for constructing the LR parsing table. First step is we have to write the augmented grammar. Now, what is the augmented grammar? If suppose P is a grammar with starting symbol S, then G dash augmented grammar for G is a grammar with a new starting symbol S dash, and productions are S derives S dash. The purpose of this new starting symbol S dash is to indicate the parser when it should stop the parsing. The dot before S indicates the left side of the dot has been read by a compiler, and the right side of the dot is yet to be read by a compiler. Second is the second step is LR of 0, collection of items is to be found. And the third is we have to define two functions, go to list of terminals and action list of non-terminals in the parsing table.
Explain with the help of an example LR0 parsing. So here is the grammar, that is E produces E plus T, E produces T, T produces E within first bracket, and T produces ID. And we have to derive the string ID plus within first bracket ID from it. So what are the steps? The steps, first steps is augmenting a grammar. Augmenting grammar is basically grammar which has gotten features with an expression little bit, that is here in the, we have got the same example, but E prime produces E. So in the next, in the similar way, E produces E plus T, E produces T, T produces first bracket E, and T produces ID. So this is the slide where I will explain the closure operations. So first is I0. In I0, we have kept the whole thing, that is the augmented grammar, but with a dot in the left-hand side of each and every element. So E not produces dot of E, E produces dot E plus T, E produces dot T, T produces dot within first bracket E, and T produces dot of ID. So first we'll shift E. So by shifting A, it's going to I1. Similar, E is there in two of this operation.
As we are explaining, so the sample string here is ID plus ID within bracket. So we have divided that into parts in the action table, and we have ID plus two brackets, and the finally the dollar version, because it is the end of the string, and it denotes that we have reached the end of ID or plus or ID, and it moves on to the next thing. So first of all, we have E and 2, because after putting E from I0, we are moving to I1. So we have 1 under E, and we have T under 2, because after moving from I0 to I2 through 3, we are having 2. Similarly, in state 1, we have S5, because after, one second, I have to find I5. Okay, so after I5, we are having it reduced to 5th state. So we have shifted to the 5th state, and we have S5 under plus, because we are using the plus version from I0 to I5. And the dollar here is accepted, because it's always the accept, and it should have been put over all other tables, but we have not, because it just denotes everything is in the accept state. And we do not have any end state over here in GoTo, so we have not put here. In number 2, we are moving from I2 to reduce state of 2. That is, we have reduced state 2, E produces T. This is the reduced state 2. And we have it reduced in the I2 version. So here is the reduced version of I2, and hence we have put R2 under I2, ID. So all of these are reduced, and all of this put R2, meaning R reduced to 2. And this is the number 2 version. And again in 3, we have shifted to 4, like just like in cell 0. And we have shifted to 3 in bracket. So the 3-1 is here in the bracket, and the S4 is here. S4 is here, ID. And in 4, we have again reduced to term number 4. Term number 4 is T produces ID, and we have reduced to number 4 in I04. So that is I4, and we have reduced to T gives ID dot. So we have parsed through the whole string of ID, that's why the dot is behind the ID. So we have reached the reduced state, and we have put reduced state number 4 in I4. And all of this chase sample string here is ID plus ID. And the rules number here are 1 through 4. And it gives E produces E plus T, E produces T, T produces E within brackets, and T produces ID. So these are the rules we have, 4 rules. And here we are having states. And here we have action table and go to table. So from I0, we are moving to I1 through E. So we have put 1 under the go to table. And here we have put shift to 4 under ID, because we have shifted to shifted to 4 through the I0 part, and we have put ID under S4. And similarly, we have put S3 under the bracket, because we have moved to I3 with using the bracket. And in 1, we have shifted to 5. So I5 is over here. We have shifted to from I0 to I5 over here, and it gives E produces E plus dot T, meaning we have not yet reached the end of E plus T. We have reached just after the plus. And T produces dot within brackets E, so we have not yet reached the reduced state. And T produces ID dot ID, so we have not yet reached the end of that too. So, and dollar sign here stands for the end of the string. So we have put accept over here, and all these cells represent accept, but we have just put under one thing. And similarly, again, for 2, we have reduced to rule number 2 from 2. So I0 to I2, we have reduced to 3, and we have reached rule number 4, rule number 2, that is E produces T over here. So we have put reduced 2 in all of the boxes. And for number 3, we have again we have shift to 4, again ID similar to S0, and shift to 3 similar to 0 again. And here from I3 to I6, so from I3 to I6, we have used E and reached T gives E dot, and we have reached E produces E dot plus T. So we have put T over here from E, because we have used E here. And from I3 to I2. So from I3 to I2, we have used T again and reached to 2. So we have put T over, so we have put 2 under T. So similarly for 4, just like 2, we have reduced to rule number 4. So that is rule number 4 gives T gives ID. And we have again I4 over here that gives T gives ID dot. That means we have reached the end of T produces ID, because we have the dot at the end of ID. So we have reached rule number 4. So we have reduced to 4 in all of these boxes, just like we had in number 2. So again in 5, similar to 2 and 0, we have shifted to 4 and shifted to 3 using ID and bracket. And 6, again, we have shifted to 5 and shifted to 7 using plus and bracket. And 7. 7, we have reduced to rule number 3. So rule number 3 is T produces E within bracket. And I7 over here is T produces E within bracket dot. The dot represents, again, that we have reached the end of the string. T produces E, dot, E, dot, E within brackets. So we have reduced it to rule number 3. That's why we have put reduced to 3, that is R3, within all of the boxes. And finally, in I8, we have reduced to rule number 1, that is E produces E plus T. Again, here, I8 gives E produces E plus T dot. That again denotes that we have reached the end of the string. So we have put R1 in all of these boxes, denoting reduced to rule number 1. Stack implementation of the string we have shown earlier, that is ID plus ID within brackets. So here we are having a stack implementation going on. That is, again, for the shift reducing parsing table. And it is again a type of bottom type parser. So we are using stack to hold grammar symbols. And we are shifting the input symbols onto the stack until a handle comes on top of the stack, like it comes in second and third steps. So when a handle occurs on top of the stack, it implements reduction. So firstly, we are using these 4 rules to reduce. And we have $0 again. The string symbol here again represents the end of the string. So firstly, we have $0 and we have the input string, that is ID plus ID within brackets and the dollar symbol. And the action here is shift ID to S4. And then $0 ID to 4, and we are having input plus ID dollar sign, and we are reducing this string using rule number 4, that is T produces ID. So we are already reducing this because it is a handle, so our reduction occurs in second step. And the stack of stack number 3, again we are having $0 T2, and the input here is plus ID within bracket dollar symbol. Again, this is reducing to a handle, so we are reducing this using rule number 2, that is E produces T over here. And then again, we have the stack $0 E1. We are giving input plus ID dollar symbol, and we are shifting using the S5, like we have shown earlier over here. S5 was shifted. Again, $0 E1 plus 5 gets used. So the input string here is ID within bracket dollar, because the plus sign shifts here. And the action here is shifting the bracket, that is S3. Sorry, one second. So $01. So finally, now we have on the stack is 0E1 plus 5 and bracket 3. And the input string over here has transformed to ID bracket dollar from the original string. And we have shifted this ID through S4. And then again, we move it to stack, and we have 0E1 plus 5, 3ID4. And the input string is bracket and the dollar symbol. And this is again a handle situation. So we are reducing this using rule number 4, that is T produces ID. And then again, we are getting one more step that gives again a reduction step and again a handle situation. So the reduction step, we are using it as rule number 2. So that is E produces T. So again, there's a change over here, and we have an input string bracket dollar sign. So the action over here is shift to S7, as we have shown earlier. So again, the stack changes to $0E1 plus 5, 3, 6 within bracket, then 7. So the input string has now transformed into dollar symbol from the original string, that is ID plus ID within brackets. This is again a handle situation. So we are having a reduction over here using rule number 3. So rule number 3 is T produces E within brackets. So there's a change over here again, and we are having $0E1 on the stack plus 5T8. The input string again here is dollar, because there is no change. And this is again a handle situation. We are reducing it using rule number 1, that is E produces E plus T, which is the final state of the stack implementation. And finally, we have the input string as ID plus ID within bracket dollar. Finally the dollar, which again denotes the end of the string. So we have passed totally through the string. The sample string, we have taken an example, ID plus ID dollar, and therefore we reach the acceptance state. So that's all.
Very good. Thank you. Shreya, whenever you present, you all make it your PPT, all diagrams will be available in one screenshot. Shreya.
So what is CLR1 parsing? The CLR parser stands for canonical LR parser. It is a more powerful LR parser. CLR1 represents canonical collection of LR1 items to construct the CLR1 parsing table. CLR1 parsing table makes the more number of states as compared to the SLR1 parsing. Now here are the steps for constructing CLR1 parsing. First one is write the augmented grammar. An augmented grammar is any grammar whose productions are augmented with conditions expressed using features. Like if a grammar G is having a start symbol S, then augmented grammar is a new grammar G naught in which S naught is a new start symbol such that S naught produces S. Next, find LR1 collection of items. And the last step is defining two functions, go to list of terminals and action list of non-terminals.
I will be discussing the LR1 collection of items. It is similar to the LR0 collection of items, but we have one look ahead added to each and every step. So first there is this augmented production s-2 dot s, and its look ahead will be dollar. Then we expand s to s2 dot cc, and as because the follow of s is dollar, so the look ahead in the next step will be dollar. Now we have to expand the c to its production, that is c to dot cc, and as because the follow of c is c or d, so we have to so the look ahead will be c or d. Again c to dot d, its look ahead will be c or d. Now we shift s from i0. If we shift s, we go to i1 state, and it is accepting state. Its production is s-2 s dot, and the look ahead is dollar. From i0, if you shift c, we go to i2 state. The productions are s to c dot c dollar, c to dot cc dollar, and c to dot d dollar. From i0, if you shift c, then the productions are c to c dot c, and as because the follow of, like from the previous step only we got the look ahead c or d, so here also the look ahead will be c or d, but from the next step we have to expand this c production, so we get c to dot cc and c to dot d, and as because the follow of c is c or d, so here the look ahead will be c or d. Again for this step also the look ahead will be c or d. Now from i0, if we shift d, we get c to d dot, and the look ahead is c or d. From step i2, if we shift capital C, we go to state i5. If we shift small c, we go to state i6, and if we shift small d, we go to state c to d dot dollar. And from i3, if we shift capital C, we go to state i8. If we shift small d, we go to state i4, and if we shift small c, it again loops back to itself only. From i5, there is no shift to any other state. From i6, if we shift capital C, we go to i9 state. If we shift small d, we go to i7 state. And if we shift small c, we go to, like it loops back to itself only. Now comes the parsing table. In the parsing table, in the states, we have the state 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up till 9. Like the items which we had in LR1 collection of items, those items will be in the state. And under action, we write the terminals, and under go to, we write the variables. So in state 0, after shifting S, in state 0, after shifting S, we go to I1. So under S, we will write 1. In state 0, after shifting capital C, we go to state I2. So under C, we will write 2. In state 0, after shifting small c, we go to state I3. So under action, under C, we will write S3. In state I0, after shifting small d, we go to I4. So under D, we will write S4. As I1 is the accepting state, so here under dollar, we will write accept. Similarly, for state I2, if we shift capital C, we go to I5. So under C, we write 5. If we shift small c, we go to I6. So under small c, and in the row 2, we'll write S6. And if we shift small d, we'll move to state I7. So we write S7. So like that. Now the step 4, we move on to the step 4. The step 4, the step 4, now this is a reduction rule, C to D dot, this is a reduction rule. So as because this is a reduction rule, we will have to write R3 in the state 4, but unlike as in the LR0 parsing table, we were writing under all the terminals R3. Here we won't do that. Only in the look ahead values we will write R3. So here look ahead is C and D. So here under C and D column we'll write R3. Now for state 5, the state 5 is also again a reduction rule, and it is the rule number 1. So it is rule number 1. So as because its look ahead is dollar, so only under the dollar we will write R1. Similarly for state 6, on shifting C we go to 9, so under C we'll write 9. On shifting D we go to 7, so under D we write S7. And on shifting small c it loops back to itself, so under small c we'll write S6. Like that we fill up the complete parsing table. Now there is a stack implementation. So here these are the grammar rules, S to CC and CC to D, and this is our string CD CD. So we will derive this string from the grammar. So initially the state is 0 because we are starting from the item number 0. Now we will see row number 0 and terminal C. So in row number 0 and terminal C we are getting S3. So shift C to S3. So in the stack we'll shift C and 3. Now we'll see row number 3 and input D. So in row number 3 and input D there is S4. So we'll shift D to S4. So D in the stack we push D, and then there is 4. Now 4 and C. So in the 4 and C there is this reduction rule R3, and the rule R3 is C to D. So in the stack we'll replace D4 by C. So the stack input right now is 03C. Now we'll go to C of 3. So this is C and it's 3 gives us 8. So after C we'll write 8. Now for 8 and C we'll get the reduced rule R2, and the R2 rule is C to CC. So we'll replace C3 C8 by capital C. And for C and 0 from this parsing table, C and the 0th row will get value 2. So this value 2 we will write after C. Now for 2 and C there is this rule shift C to S6. So we'll shift C to the stack and then also the value 6. Now for 6 and D there is this S7. So we'll shift D to the stack, push D to the stack, and also the value 7. Now our input is exhausted, just only this dollar is left. So for 7 and dollar, the rule is reduce R3. And the actual R3 rule is C to D. So we'll replace D7 by C. And in C of 6, there is value 9. In C of 6 there is value 9, so we will write 9 after C. And then in 9 of dollar there is reduction rule C to CC. So in CC we'll write capital C, and in C of 2 we'll write 5. So there is this 5, and then there 5 of dollar there is this reduction rule S to CC. So C to C5 will be replaced by S, and in S of 0 we have 1. In S of 0 there is this 1, which is accepting state. So finally from this row we get that the string is accepted by the parser. SLR parser is more powerful than LALR. The parsers CLR and LALR have the same power, so obviously CLR parser is the most powerful parser. So option C will be the correct answer. Then what is the similarity between LR, LALR and SLR? The options are, so obviously all the algorithms are similar, but while constructing the parsing table, the reduction rules are put under different variables. So this option that is used, same algorithm but different parsing table, will be the correct one. If a state does not know whether it will make a shift operation or reduction for a terminal, it's called. So the answer will be shift reduce conflict, because if there is a shift operation and the reduction operation, then it's a shift reduce conflict. And when beta in the LR1 item A to beta dot A comma A is not empty, the look ahead, obviously the look ahead won't be affected, because in case of look aheads, if there is a variable then only it will be affected. And also any variable which is after the dot, that is affected. Before the dot, if any variable or terminal is there, that won't affect the look ahead. So the answer will be does not have any effect. when the parser starts constructing the parse tree from the start symbol and then tries to transform the start symbol to the input, it's called a bottom up. So obviously it will be a top down parsing, because in case of bottom up parsing, we start from the input and then we move up to the start symbol. So the answer will be B.
Very good.